Welcome to the course on Test Your C Programming Skills, a guide to crack IT interview. We are discussing fifth topic of this course, Preprocessor Directives, and this is third session on the Preprocessor Directives. Let's discuss few more types of Preprocessor Directives. Hash undefined identifier. This undefines a macro definition. Hash if defined identifier. Here, section of code is compiled only if identifier macro is already defined. Hash if not defined identifier. Here, section of code is compiled only if identifier macro is not defined. Hash if, hash else, and hash elif. These are useful to specify conditions to be met for compiling a section of code. Hash pragma is useful to specify diverse options to the compiler. Hash error is useful to generate the compiler error and it stops the compilation process. Let's move to the first example of this session. See the code carefully and guess the output. In the code, there is a macro definition on line number 3. In main function, that macro is again redefined on line number 6. And there is a printf on line number 7, which is displaying the value of num. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives 200 as output. Let's understand why we are getting 200 as output. In this program, num macro is redefined on line number 6, and this is allowed by compiler. So line number 7 refers latest definition of num, and that's why the output is 200. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a macro definition for false on line number 3. True macro is defined on line number 4 and null macro is defined on line number 5. In the main function, there is an integer variable p which is initialized to minus 1. And then there are the if and else if conditions which are displaying different types of outputs. So the correct answer of this program is, this program prints null as output. Let's understand why we are getting null as output of this program. Note that in system, true, false and null, they are already defined. After redefining it, compiler does not generate an error, but it gives an warning. So in this case, since the value of p is equal to minus 1, last condition is matched. And that's why the output is null. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a macro 1 which is defined on line number 3. And on line number 6, there is a if defined macro 1. And if this condition matches, there is a one printf message printing some text. There is a else on line number 8. If it matches, then there is a printf on line number 9. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives the output as a, since macro 1 is defined, this line will be processed by the compiler. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Note that if defined on line number 6 checks if macro 1 is already defined or not. If it is defined, then line number 7 is compiled, else line number 9 is compiled, and that's why output is as shown in the screen. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. There is a macro exp1 which is defined on line number 3. In main function on line number 6, there is if defined condition. On line number 7, there is if not defined condition. And there are printf on line number 8 and 9. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives the welcome as output. Let's understand why we are getting welcome as output of this program. In this program, nested conditions are given using preprocessor directives. In the code, exp1 macro is defined on line number 3. However, exp2 macro is not defined. So, the conditions on line number 6 and 7 both are true, and that's why the output of this program is welcome. Let's move to the next example. C See the code carefully and guess the output. On line number 3, there is a if not defined macro which checks whether math underscore h is there in the program or not. On line number 4, there is a hash error macro which gives an error message. And in the main function, there are two variables a and b. Then a is equal to square root of b, and then it is displaying the value of a. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives a compiler error saying hash error include maths.h and then compile. Let's understand why we are getting the output like this. Here in the program, line number 3 checks if math.h is included in the code. Hash error stops compilation after raising an error, and in this case this gives the message as include maths.h and then compile. In the code, since math.h is not included, the output is as given. Let's move to the next example. See the code carefully and guess the output. On line number 3, macro 1 is defined. In main function, there is a if not defined condition on line number 6. And there is a block of code if that condition matches. There is an else part on line number 12. So the correct answer of this program is, this program gives the output as a macro 2 is not defined. Let's define it here. In the code, macro 2 is not defined. Hence, condition on line number 6 is true, and that's why line number 8 displays the message, and afterwards this defines macro 2. In the next part, we'll continue the discussion on preprocessor directives. Till then, enjoy C programming.